Hey guys, it's Meg, back for another Faceup video. This is my Argo doll Nelei. I had done a video for her previously, but I didn't really enjoy the Faceup and it didn't fit her character, so I decided to change it. I don't really know what my camera was doing with this exceedingly wide angle, but it changes once it gets to the important part of the Faceup. Right now I'm basically just laying down, kind of like skin texturing or skin shading around the nose and the bridge of the nose and the eyes. I like to do this on almost all of my dolls. And here I am laying down her lip color, which before it was a normal color of like lipstick, but for her character I decided to go with purple. At this point I am trying to lay down a guideline for her eyebrows and realizing that my white watercolor will not show. Later on you see me fix this with a bit of watered down paint, acrylic paint, which is my first time using acrylic paint on a face-up. Keep trying to get that white pencil to work, but it never does. But that's the stubborn in me. And attempt number four at trying to get that white pencil to show up. You see, I give up and just go back to other parts of the face up. And deciding to lay down some eyeshadow, which didn't end up showing up either on the first couple layers. Here we go, now the camera went back to normal. I don't know what it was doing. Nelei has a mouth. house that is upturned at the corner slightly, and that is not the look I was going for at all, so I stopped my shading and my lines just short of that area of her mouth. I think it turned out rather well. Nelei has some wonderful accentuated cheekbones with just a lovely subtle curve, so I really like to blush her head that way. I always add a little bit of pink watercolor pencil to the waterline and the inner corner just to give a little extra detail. Now my least favorite part is adding the eyelid crease, which I really should just stop doing, and adding in the eyelashes, the lower lashes. I'm not very steady-handed with the watercolor pencil enough to make them thin and wispy, so they always end up coming out kind of weird looking to me. though with her face up, I did manage to get a nice pass initially with the brown. But once I tried to go over it with black, I kind of ruined it in a couple spots. I did end up going pretty heavy-handed on the eyeshadow and stuff because her eyes are so lightly colored. I figured the darker her eye makeup, the more her eyes would pop. And now begins my struggle with acrylic paint. Did not have my initial few attempts watered down enough, so it was coming out a little clumpy. By the end of it, I get the hang of it, but it was a bit of a struggle. Thankfully, it just washes off if you've got the other layers sealed. And the paintbrush that I am using is a Army Painter The Psycho. It is the smallest brush that I can find. I do apologize that some of this is out of frame. I'm not very good with keeping my work in camera frame, mostly because I pull it up to my face so I can get a good look at it. Thank you. what I'm wiping it with off screen just a moment ago is one of those little white square sponges that you get when you order from Alice's collection. I think I have about 8 of them. At this point, I have figured out that it is not watered down enough, thinned, so I go and do that, and then I wipe the eyebrows off and start over. And this works much better. After a couple attempts of getting the shape right, I settle in for finishing them up. That actually turned out a lot better than I expected. And I managed to get both eyebrows even for once. If you've seen some of my other face-up videos, you know I tend to enjoy eyebrows that are a little more fluffy or natural looking, I think is the term. It's just something I prefer. So I tend to do it with just about every doll I repaint, whether it's a Monster High or a BJD. And we're nearing the end of the video. I chose not to gloss her lips this time after I put on the mica powder. I don't know why I did that, but at any point I can go back and change it. And that about does it. So here's Thedra. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.